Epilog by Miroslav, Antić. The waterfall has beard like L.N. Tolstoy. That's actually the morning foaming itself and stretching out the rainbow. I've confessed to a woman that life is something simple inside me. But it's not all that simple. I thought I'd go straight until I turned into a ruler. But they've found me in a circle. They've found me after roaming lowered from screaming to whispering. October is gone. Between trees' legs, it slowly begins to smell of moisture and blood. The street is getting wet for the last time in the raw sun. Sit beside me for a minute, like next to a grave. A minute of silence for my deceased rosiest ages. Sit beside me for a minute. You see, I'm good again. Behind my ear, there's a hardened shaft of curdled defeat, like on an executed deserter. A great gold carriage has flown through our numb eyes, and we haven't saved it. Something young neighed on our lips and withered bitter from laughing and sweet from crying. After all, allow me to write a letter to a distant young lady, just a bit nostalgic, the way that senile retired admirals write to the surviving crew of a sunk destroyer. Miss, I will say. Miss, it's all over. In this place, dead flowers are sold, poured in perfume bottles, and everything is peaceful, as if the wind never slapped the row of trees and meddled with the window. Miss, I'll say, this autumn, as frigid as a tourist with a Scandinavian passport, the fact that I'm all of a sudden gray doesn't mean that I'm white. You were the only one to completely feed my hunger with a little flesh and dream. Only you were satiated by the little of my nails and palms. I wish your future sons would inherit the tone of my voice, and your daughters carry my sadness in silk vests. I wish you'd save my most splendid heights on the horizontals of your worst, and that you'd carry my eyes through the silence of strange eyes and apartments, and my October through all strange Aprils. This is not a confession. This is worse than a prayer. 1,000 times since this morning, I love you like in the old times. 1,000 times since this morning, I'm coming back to you. 1,000 times, I'm, again, worried about you, lost in the whirlpool of geographic maps about you, handed out like posters to who knows what kind of people. Am I still the unit by which you define who hurts you and how much the others were naked in front of you? The unit by which you know who's grabbing you and who's paying you? Am I still, among all those lives of yours, the little piece of the bluest sky in your chest and of the bloodiest honeycomb? Here, where I am, the days taste like beer and boredom. Rain sometimes drops, strangely. Serene. I have no will either to live nor to kill myself. I'm completely like a boat that wanders around with no crew and doesn't want to erase from his eyes something vain, something deceased, something tender. Maybe it's good for you to know. After you, women have no right to imagine anything. Once upon a time, the first novice in the Republic. Today, I can lift drop socks to the Mother of God herself, disguised in dignity. All of my tenderness still sleeps at your doorstep, like the little yellow dogs on wet, swollen black tits of Mrs. Female Dog. I'm completely indrawn, from mucous membrane to the soul. These 32 teeth still sob love only for you, like they used to, and still hum the same way. You surely understand me. It's all over. I'm shuddery drunk and empty and alone. Sometimes someone comes along to worryingly love me and take care of me. Someone to whom I show all of your road signs leading to my hothead. Don't ever tell anyone, but I, being the one to know the least about happiness, would like to give a bit of clumsy happiness to that someone new. And while the trees are dying and the wind is stepping on the leaves, I'd like that someone to feel good in the name of a certain aorist of my love and of the past perfect tense. Maybe you won't believe it. I finished with hotels completely unnoticed. All hotels somehow resemble the same fairy tale, and beds in the room smile at me in the same way. All the doormen worry in the same way, a bit friendly when we tell them goodnight. All the doormen worry in that same way, I swear, as if they know about us. There's nothing more I'd like to tell you, drunk from coldness. Saturday night stumbles around. The clocks have long ago played taps. There's really nothing further I'd like to tell you. Maybe only that you're still the most beautiful metal from the most beautiful war in which they amputated my heart. Miss, I wasn't just ordinarily, in a high school kind of way, infatuated. Everything inside me, down to my soul's, was mined. By the way, I've remembered. Love is the sweetest only in the cries given to the first ones. Therefore, allow me to smile in this autumn because of something inside me, a bit secretly, through tears, a bit out of style. Me, your most gentle stallion among poets. Me, your most ruthless poet among stallions.